Paris, the city of lights, love and a dream destination. Our challenge was to cover this beautiful city in one day, which is going to be tough and you're not going to do justice with this time frame in hand. However, we tried our best and you tell me if it was a success. So keep watching till end as I'm going to show you how to do Paris in one day.
Train abhi hum log Paris mein land kar gaye hain. Yay!
It all started with us reaching Paris North Station. I can't tell you how happy we were.
This is Hotel Libertal Montmartre Opera. It's a 3-star property with approx 50 rooms and with a rating of 8.1 by Agoda. In front of this is a beautiful Italian restaurant called Pink Mama. You should definitely try some Italian delicacies here. Now let me take you inside. We took a family room and it costed just 15 euros from booking.com. Our room was at the top floor, 603, with a queen size bed and an extra bed for the child. My first impression, room looked clean but small and had basic amenities like a safe, TV, coffee maker, mini fridge and water heater. But the best part of this room was the amazing view from the balcony, where I can look down the street and I can see Eiffel Tower at night. Also, street was so lively at night as I heard there are a couple of nightclubs around here. But don't worry, closing the windows cuts the noise completely. Washroom was small but clean and workable. To hang your clothes, you have small open wardrobes at the entrance of the room.
We started our day trip by visiting Arc de Triomphe. It is a monument that was built to honor those who fought and died for France in the French Revolution. You can enjoy walking around the base and under the arches of the Arc de Triomphe for free, or pay a fee to climb 280 stairs to the top of the monument for a lovely view of the city. The ticket cost is 13 euros. Please note, for children and adults under 18, it is free on certain days of the month. It sits on a circular plaza from which 12 roads come out. There are underground tunnels which can take you to this central structure, Arc de Triomphe. Next destination was to Palais de Chaillot. This is near Trocadéro metro station and to reach here from Arc de Triomphe is pretty easy. Just take the metro line 6 to Trocadéro station. Palais de Chaillot is best place for taking Eiffel Tower photos because you won't have to worry about crowd as there is ample space for getting a clear shot of Eiffel Tower. Next, you can get down the stairs to get closer to Eiffel Tower. But before we proceed, we had some snacks from an amazing roadside food stall, where we had a tasty hot dog, even though most of the people were having crepe. It was windy and raining, but we loved it.
These are the crepes.
Finally, the best place to take more pics is from Pont d'Iéna, which is a bridge spanning the river Seine.
To speed things up, we will do a hop-on hop-off ride on River Seine, for which we will choose Bateau bus service. It covers 9 stations and all stops have some attractions around them. We are starting from Eiffel Tower and we will go around to visit all these places. ये व्यू है पीछे एफिल टावर का यहाँ से. अभी हम लोग यहाँ से बस को चढ़ेंगे. $17 इसका टिकट का दाम है फॉर एडल्ट, और छोटे बच्चों के लिए इट्स 8 यूरोस. अगर आपको सिर्फ 1 आवर क्रूज करनी है तो यू कैन गो अदर साइड, देयर अदर बोट्स एज वेल, दे आर लिटिल चीपर देन दिस.
हेलो,
2 टिकट्स फॉर एडल्ट एंड 1 फॉर चाइल्ड.
थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस
डे. सो दिस इज 1 पास, 9 स्टेशन, सो यू हॉप ऑन एंड हॉप ऑफ.
The first thing to see was the Palais Bourbon, which serves as a meeting place of the French National Assembly, the lower legislative chamber of the French government. It is located on the left bank of the Seine River. Next, we saw Musée d'Orsay, which is a museum on the left bank of the Seine River. It is housed in the former Gare d'Orsay, which was a railway station built in 1900s. As the station had short platforms which were unable to accommodate larger trains, later it was turned into a museum. Today, this museum holds mainly French art, including paintings, sculptures, furniture, and photography. Opening timings are 9:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. on all days, with extended hours on Thursdays. The ticket price of this museum is around 18 euros, which is a combined ticket. Next stop was beneath the bridge Pont du Carrousel, where we got down to cross the bridge. There are 4 stone sculptures, one at each corner on the bridge, representing River Seine. The view when you cross the spectacular bridge is amazing. This bridge is one of the new bridge which gives a grand entry to the Louvre Palace, where you have the Louvre on the entrance. The Louvre is the world's largest museum, which exhibits sculptures, arts, paintings, drawings, and archaeological finds. Louvre provides with some excellent photo-taking opportunity, and we took some amazing and funny shots. Now, we did not go inside Louvre because we are here for 1 day and have lot to cover, but I will recommend to visit this place. Some of the best paintings in the Louvre are the Raft of Medusa, Mona Lisa, Wedding at Cana, and many more. Ticket price is 17 euro if you pre-book, while it's 15 euro at the counter. For opening timings and the latest prices, visit the website, the link for which is provided in the description. At the same place, you can see Arc de Triomphe du Carrousel, which was built between 1806 to 1808 to commemorate Napoleon's military victories of the previous year. This is the smallest of the 3 arches. The arc is crowned with a bronze chariot. We boarded the boat again and continued our ride to see numerous bridges and houses showing the awesome French architecture. The next famous building we saw was Notre Dame Cathedral. It is considered a jewel of medieval Gothic architecture. Construction started in 1163 and it was not completed until 1345. It is famous for 3 stained glass rose windows and towers of Notre Dame, which you can climb to have a beautiful view from the top. It had a devastating fire on April 15, 2019 and has been closed from then, so do check out if things have changed. Next up was the spiked conical towers with exteriors painted grey called the Conciergerie. It was once the most notorious prison in all of France, but presently used mostly for law courts.
The boat ride was worth every penny, after which we went back to a hotel to get ready for the finale, which was to see Paris from top of the Eiffel Tower. First thing first, you need to ensure you book your ticket in advance, as we were unable to get ticket to the summit, hence we bought ticket for the second floor. Do note, there are several places you can book your ticket like Klook and various travel sites, but I would recommend trying your luck first with the Eiffel Tower tourist site. Ticket cost 17 euros for adult, 4 for child and 8 euros for young, which is for second floor, while for summit it costs 26 euros for adult, 13 for young and 650 for the child. We got the last lot to visit Eiffel Tower, which was around 11 something. By this time, we were very tired, but seeing the crowd filled with energy, we once again got our energy back. The lift to the second floor of the Eiffel Tower. The view was breathtaking at the top. I really wanted to go to the top of Eiffel Tower, but maybe Paris wants me to come back again.
One day is over and time to say goodbye to Paris and visit Zurich, Switzerland. We came into Paris through Paris North Station and right now we are at Paris Gare de Lyon Station, from where we will take a train to Zurich, Switzerland. Before we boarded, we grabbed some snacks for the train.
Boat 16, yes, this one.
फाइनली हम लोग अब ज्यूरिख के लिए स्टार्ट हो गए हैं, तो हम लोगों ने ट्रेन पकड़ ली है पेरिस से ज्यूरिख जाने के लिए, तो ये अभी 7:24 पे हाँ स्विट्जरलैंड में ज्यूरिख जा रहे हैं ना, तो उस जगह का नाम ज्यूरिख है जहाँ स्विट्जरलैंड में जा रहे हैं, उसकी हमने ट्रेन पकड़ ली है। 7:24 की ट्रेन थी, भागते भागते हमने ट्रेन पकड़ी है और दो सीट्स हमारी इधर हैं, एक सीट जम्मू की इस साइड है, तो वो भी बैठी हुई है अपना, और ये पहुँचेगी 11:30 तक। कोच तो वैसे ही है जैसे हम एम्स्टरडैम से पेरिस में आए थे, और इस तरह से पीछे भी आप देख सकते हो ऐसा लग रहा है इस तरह से।